हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ रविंद्र जायसवाल वेलकमिंग यू ऑल इन दिस ब्यूटीफुल ट्यूटोरियल ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ SST कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट्स एंड कॉमर्स उल्लासनगर 4। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वेरी सिंपल बट वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक, दैट इज पिवोट टेबल। नाउ व्हाट इज पिवोट टेबल? सो लेट मी एक्सप्लेन यू दिस इन अ वेरी वेरी सिंपल टर्म, दैट पिवोट टेबल इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ समराइज टेबल। Consider a scenario that you are working in a very big industry which have like data, which have like multiple data, like bulk of data which is present in that industry. Like suppose there is a record of employee which consists of 10,000 records, and your work is to find the statistic of that particular record. So when you are using a simple Excel and simple table views, you have to go through each and every records individually to find out the final stats, statistics, any other mathematical calculations. What pivot tables does, it helps you to do the quick calculations and summarize your data in a short format. Like whatever you require, you can summarize that data into smaller concept without going to each and every field individually. Let's see how it can be done. In this tutorial I am using Excel. This pivot table can be supported by various version of Microsoft data analyst we can use different data analyst softwares, like Microsoft provide Power BI also for the same purpose, but we are using today a simple Excel table which also support the same pivot table and pivot graph facility. Let's see how it's done. The pivot table is available in any version of a Microsoft Excel. It can be available in 7, 10, 12, 16 and latest one 19. The functionality and the steps are always same. I have downloaded a simple sample table like this. You can see in this sheets it consists of different data. It consists of n number of data. In total, if I can say, you can see it consists of 701 data and it also consists of multiple fields. By looking at the fields also you can understand what kind of data it is. It consists of segment, country, it consists of a sales data which represent a particular companies, products, their discounts, unit sold, manufacturing, sales prices, etc. So it is not possible for a single person to go through each and every record and to analyze this data and create a summary of this particular data. So this can be done by using simple pivot table. So in order to create a pivot table, go to insert option. On the left side you can see a pivot table option, click on that. We have two options in order to create a pivot summaries. One we can create in the form of pivot table and other one we can create in the form of pivot chart. Pivot chart will be doing in the next tutorial. Today we are going to cover pivot table. Click on pivot table, you can see this is the option. By default all table is selected. You can see select a target or range. If you don't want to analyze all data, you can select a specific part of a table also. By default I am choosing all the table. Or you can use a different external connection data source. Means data which is available on different resources or different places, that also can be implemented or imported into this particular pivot table. But currently I am using this current table. The table name is financial. Downside we can see we have two options where to create our pivot table, in a new worksheet or existing worksheet. If you create on an existing worksheet, the pivot table will be created just on the side of your current worksheet. I need a new worksheet so that reference can be very easy, or you can create a different location by clicking on the location option. Click on OK, it will create a new sheet. You can see on the left side, this is the pivot table is created. The pivot table is created, but it not showing any kind of data. Why? Because we have to summarize data. The summarization can be done depending on a specific task. Like one day the task can be different, other day the task can be different. On the right side you can see it consists of different field. It means you don't have to go to each and every field in order to summarize data. Whatever data you require, you just choose those field. And below you have four filter option. We'll talk one by one. we'll implement it and we'll see how it's work. We can see the row label is very important. Suppose if I want to see all the countries information, so click and drag the country into row label. You can see on the left side of pivot table, it shows data in the it shows all the countries in a row wise. The benefit of this pivot table that it does not show repetitive data. As you can see on the original sheets, country consists of repetitive data like Canada, Germany, France, Germany is again repeated, Mexico, Germany, Germany, Germany is repeated, Canada is again repeated. So pivot table is like only unique existence available. So summarization can be very easy. You can see on the side of row label there is a value that is value field or value filter. We can just simplify any numeric value over there in order to do the stats or statistics data. Like suppose if I am taking a sales price, it will show a country wise sales price to me. You can see the value is sum of sales price. So in Canada the total sales price is $16,580. Similarly for France, Mexico, United States and grand total is this. If you will see the value, again you can see a drop down list. Click on that value field setting. Go to value field setting. You can change the value also. By default it's showing sum. You can go for the count also, for average, maximum, minimum and other values also. So depend on your like standard deviation and other data. You can see it shows the so you can see we can change the value also. By default it's sum, average, maximum, min and count. These are the basic values which we can change, and you can change the name also of the field. By default it says average of a cell. If I want to say Ravi average, it can be renamed as Ravi average. You can see. So basic customization. Then there is a column label. Whatever data you want to see in the column wise, you can click and drag data in the column label also, just like we did in a row label. Suppose month number I am click and dragging on report filter. So by default if you want to choose a report for a month wise, like suppose you can see month number, it shows all. You can click and drag again it. Suppose if I am taking month name, so by default on the drop down list you can see month name, it shows all 12 month. So if you want to see individual month report, you can click on that particular month. Suppose if I want to see the February report, I can click on February. If I want to see April report, I can click on April. Let's see it. So in column level I want to see units sold. You can see these are the different products and n number of units sold. Or just we can take a different one, that is sales. So you can see on the February month a particular Canada does this sales, France, Germany, Mexico. Similarly we can go for the other month. You can see data will be changed. So according to the month, the number of cells occur in that particular country is showing. So this is how we can summarize our data in a short manner. That's it for today.